Welcome to the Sophistic Result Viewer documentation. In this video we will show how you can manage the filters in Result Viewer. To save time, we have already opened a prepared Result Viewer project as a standalone application. The Result Viewer can be also opened as a SSD task, but the principle how to manage the filters is same. Let's open a prepared table item where the internal forces and moments are shown. As you can see, per default, the quick filter will show one empty filter row. If you want to add a new filter row, then just click on the Add Filter button. To delete a filter row, just click on the Remove Filter button. It is important to know how the filter rules are working. In vertical direction, combining different rows, the OR logical operator will be applied between multiple filters. Per row, when adding filter to different columns, the AND logical operator will be applied. So what you see here on the screen is following. First filter filters out the values where beam is equal to 1001 and the xi value is equal to 0. Second filter filters out the values where beam is equal to 1002 and the xi value is equal to 1. Third filter filters out the all values where beam is equal to 1005. At end we will get the sum of all three filters, because vertically, the OR logical operator will be applied. The quick filter provides relational operators, logical NOT, wildcards for text columns, range, and looping. Let's first explain the syntax for the relational operators. The quick filter allows the operators equal, not equal, greater than, less than, greater or equal, less than or equal. Let's demonstrate how to use those operators in this example. Let's filter out a beam that is equal to number 1005. To do this, just type 1005 into the beam filter column. As you can see, the filter mechanism filtered out immediately the beam 1005 at real time. Per default, if the operator symbol is missing, then the equals symbol will be taken. So this input is equivalent to equals 1005. To filter out all values that are less than 1005, just add the symbol less before 1005. To filter out all values that are greater, just add the symbol greater. To filter out all values that are greater or equal, just add the symbols greater and equals. To filter out all values that are less or equal, just add the symbols less and equals. To show all values that are not equal to 1005, just use the logical NOT. Use the exclamation mark symbol. The exclamation mark symbol, which represents the logical NOT, can be combined with the other operators. If you want to filter out a range of values, then you can do it by using the range syntax. For the ranges we used the square brackets. Let's demonstrate how to use range filter on this example. Let's filter out only the beam results where the shear force is in range from 0 to 100, including the boundary values. To do it, follow the next syntax. First type the left square bracket, then the left boundary value, which is 0. Then add a semicolon, used as a separator, then the right boundary value, which is 100. Then use the right square bracket to finalize the range input. If you want to exclude the range boundary values, then just flip the square bracket to opposite direction. You can do it for left or right range boundary. The filter mechanism supports also loop filtering for columns with integer values. As an example, to filter out all beams from 1002 to 1006 with an increment of 2, you need to do following. Start with a left round bracket, then type the value from which the loop filter will start. In our case, this is the value 1002. Then use the semicolon as separator. Then type the end value of the filter loop. In our case, this is the value 1006. Then again use the separator and add the increment value of 2. Close the filter by using a right round bracket. Next important filter feature, which works only on columns that have text value, is the wildcard filter. By using wildcards you may replace one or any number of characters. The question mark symbol matches a single character. The asterisk symbol matches 0 or more characters. Let's demonstrate it on this example. Let's filter out all load cases that are containing a text wind. In next table, let filter all HEB steel profiles that have a prefix 200 in the name. As you can see, this filter option can be very useful in many cases. In case you want to hide the filter table, then just click on the filter toggle button from the ribbon menu. If you want to clear all filters, then just click on the button clear all from filter ribbon group. To temporarily deactivate or activate the filters, just use the checkbox on the left vertical header of the table. Activate all or deactivate all can be also used via context menu. At last we want to show that you can use the filter also for graphic elements. We will show this on an already prepared graphic item, where the polygon points are shown. First convert the graphic to table. Then filter out the data that you want to see in the graphic. Then convert the item back from table to graphic and you will see only the filtered values. This can be very helpful if you have text overlapping in the graphic visualization. We hope that you will like the new quick filter. In case you have a feedback, then do not hesitate to contact us. This is the end of the video. Thank you for your attention.